Hello, welcome to Mahoosuc Land Trust, Habitat for All Pollinator Garden. I'm Barbara Murphy, staff member with the Land Trust, but more importantly, I am part of an amazing volunteer team that in under 2 years transformed a weedy, overgrown squash patch into a 10,000 square foot pollinator garden. It is magnificent. It is beyond description, and I can hardly wait to show it to you. In the past couple of years, we taught this class live. However, the coronavirus has provided us with these new opportunities to learn some skills and to reach a wider audience like you. So welcome. Thank you for joining us, and let's get started. So the first question probably is, why a pollinator garden? The garden was created in response to the rapid global decline of insects. We are going to talk a lot about that later. But it was also created as MLT's response to what can we do? How can we, as a land trust, create habitat, show our visitors what they can do in their backyards, in their communities? So our hope is that while you take the course, you learn the techniques, the tools, you get your questions answered, you get inspired to transform some part of your backyard, your community, into a pollinator oasis. So what are some topics we're going to cover this time around? Next week, we're going to hit threats globally and locally, what we can do about that. What about design of a garden? We'll cover the basics of that. Native versus non-native, a huge topic right now. Lots of press about that. Also, where to buy your plants. When you're dealing with a pollinator garden, how those plants are produced is a critical question. What about features in your garden? Could you add nesting boxes or a water feature? Either of those may attract additional pollinators to your garden, increasing your success. And finally, we hope to include little video clips of what's actually happening in the garden, and the garden at Valentine Farm. Not right yet, though. We have a little bit more snow to melt, but I look forward to sharing them with you. Initially, if you have questions or comments, why don't you just email them to me at barbara@mahoosuc.org. That email address will appear at the end of this video. If there's enough interest, I will develop some way that we can communicate privately with our questions and comments. But until then, let's just use that email. So that's the game plan. Next week, we're going to cover threats to pollinators and Habitat for All, Mahoosuc Land Trust's response to those threats. Until then, I invite you to click on the link below and enjoy the sights and sounds of a garden at high summer. Until next week.